studio with our round dancers. And what's round dancing, Ralph? Our guests are Ralph Driscoll and Ken Ryder and Bernie Ryder. So thank you all very much for coming. But tell me, what is round dancing? I know about square dancing.
Well, there is some kind of a relationship.
There is.
Most of the people that get into round dancing have started with square dancing.
Oh, is that right?
So they improve to get to the round dancing.
So it's
Ken
not...
can give you a better idea on the total thing.
Yep.
As to what it consists of.
Round dancing is really choreographed ballroom dancing. Okay. We dance as couples.
Okay.
And we dance to cues, to pre-cued dances, choreographed dances. And the figures we use are basic ballroom figures.
Mm-hmm.
And so we'll dance different rhythms. We'll dance waltz, we'll dance foxtrot, we'll dance cha-cha. They call it round dancing because we dance in a circle, all right?
Okay.
So all the couples will dance in a circle counterclockwise, at least hopefully. That means we don't run into each other on a small dance floor. Okay.
And you're using basically the same dance steps, I presume.
Correct.
Yeah.
What is really fun is if you can observe people round dancing, and it's beautiful to see them all moving around in one circle, all doing the same step at the same time. It's almost like choreographed or syncopated swimming.
Syncopated what?
Syncopated swimming. You know, if you watch people in a pool,
sure.
And it looks the same way when everyone is executing
idea.
The same step at the same time.
Well, you all did a nice performance for a talent show last year, as I recall.
We did.
Yeah, and I recall that, and I remember exactly what you're talking about and how well you did it. I thought that was great.
Yeah.
And I hope you participate this year in the talent show.
We're looking forward to it. Our dancers had a great time. With a cha-cha, that was a lot of fun, okay?
Yeah. Okay. Well, what else are we going to talk about?
What else are we going to talk about? We're really going to talk about how, I was going to say a few words about how I got into round dancing.
Oh, okay, how did you?
Well, I had a friend by the name of Trudy Keogh, and she introduced me to square dancing.
Yeah.
As I mentioned before, this is the way that most of our people actually got into it. So we took some square dance lessons for about 30 weeks, in fact, rather complicated, and by the time we got through, we joined one of the square dance clubs.
Mm-hmm.
Well, these square dance clubs, apparently, at that time we didn't know that, but they do what they call two by twos. They do two tips of square dancing and two tips of round dancing.
Oh.
So we were rather surprised to see this other dance or this other thing that was happening there. So then we started off and took some lessons in round dancing.
Mm-hmm.
So that's basically how we got into it. We took round dance lessons initially in the Pentagon.
Oh.
In the concourse in the Pentagon.
This was a while ago then.
This is quite a while ago.
That's right. Yeah, right. Yeah. When you could get into the Pentagon, yeah. Right?
Yeah, I'm older than I appear to be, right? but I don't want to get into that too much, right?
Yeah.
Anyway, so that's basically how we got into the round dancing thing.
Yeah.
One of the nice things about round dancing is that you have, when you get into these clubs, then they have special events and so on like that.
Yeah.
And that's nice because you get to meet other people. And they have regional events, and they have national events.
Festivals.
And mm-hmm. they become rather large. In fact, they've got a local one coming up here
a couple of events. We have there's a Round Dance Teachers Association of the Washington area.
Uh-huh.
Bernie and I are presidents this year.
Oh.
And we're going to have a snowflake ball. Assuming that weather will cooperate on the second Sunday in February, and then
I just assume not have any snowflakes on the second Sunday.
Well, we'll dance to some snow dances,
okay.
But we're hoping to be able to dance without any undue weather issues.
Good.
And we also have a regional festival the third mm-hmm. weekend in March. At the Mark Hilton Hotel in Alexandria,
okay.
Where there is both square dancing and round dancing, and we encourage people to come out, take a look, and I know a number of Green Spring folks dance square dance
sure.
on Tuesdays,
sure.
and we have several of the Green Spring folks dancing with us on Mondays from 1 to 3.
Yeah. So you all dance on Mondays at 1 to 3, is that your
correct
here?
That's yes.
Right. How many are in the group?
If everybody shows up, we probably 11. Have 5 or 6 couples.
Right. Yeah.
In fact, we had virtually the full group doing that demonstration at the talent show.
Okay.
And I think we had 5 couples.
Now, when did you start the round dance group here?
Sir?
When did you start the round dance group here?
Oh my, when did we start?
Probably at least good 4 years ago.
Yeah,
maybe.
three or four years ago.
But you all started it.
Yes.
Ralph okay, did. You initiated it.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, good.
I finally talked these good people into coming and do it.
Okay.
I wanted to have it here anyway.
We've known Ralph and danced with him probably like 30 years.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah.
Well, the point I wanted to make was that you started the round dance group because you wanted a round dance group, and that's one of the things that is so great around here is
that's
we
correct.
Can start things that we like to do.
Yes.
Yeah.
And as you said, that was quite a while ago. I think I was 8 or 9 years old at the time. Well, maybe that's a bit of an exaggeration. But these festivals.
That's when they were dancing. I remember now the waltzes and so forth, the Washington's Time and that so forth. That's what we're talking about, right?
Yeah. Mm. These festivals can be a pretty big affair. The Bosco one that Ken was just talking about, we'll normally get something like 1,100 or 1,200 dancers.
Oh, is that right?
So it's a big thing.
And where do you hold them?
At the Mark.
The Mark Plaza. Hilton Hotel in Alexandria, right off
Beauregard.
What we used to call Shirley Highway and Seminary Road.
Oh, okay.
That's okay.
Right. Oh, the Hilton Hotel there?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's a big tower.
Oh, yeah.
It's there. Yep.
With a hole in it on the side.
Probably does have a hole in it.
It used to be the Radisson.
Could have been.
Yeah. Right. That's what, yeah.
And you know, Ken and Bernie are going to do a little demonstration of round dancing.
Okay, well, why don't we do that? Because we've got about 5 minutes left.
All right. What we will do, we do a number of different rhythms, as I said earlier. What we're going to show you is a rhythm called bolero, right? It's a Cuban love music, right? That's where the rhythm originated from Cuba.
Okay.
And the other thing I'll say about round dancing is round dancing has different levels, what we call phases, okay? And then the phases will run from 1 to 6. Again, for each rhythm that we do, there'll be a different phase. And the level of the complexity of the step and determines the phase for the dance that's being done. We will demonstrate a song called Sleeping Beauty Bolero, which is a phase 5. So it's a fairly high level dance.
So you need to take your
My mic off.
Okay.
You got your dance shoes on?
I have my dance shoes on.
Good.
And let us get up.
And Bernie has her, and we have the music, do we?
We do have the music. We
yes.
Okay.
Okay. Diane's got the music. Now, should we get out of the way here? Or?
Well, what we'll do is we'll pretend that this is our wall.
Okay.
And this will be a reverse line of dance, and this will be our line of dance. Okay.
You got
so as I said, round dancing, we dance in a circle. Okay.
I should get up.
Sleeping Beauty, Phase 5 Bolero. Our starting position is an open V looking reverse with trailing feet free. Man's right, ladies left. We have one measure weight. We'll step to reverse with an arm sweep. Side lunge reverse with an arm sweep. Recover and shape to your partner. And hip rock, slow, quick. New Yorker to line. Spot turn to reverse.
You're painting a
turning basic,
picture,
2 measures. Take her to the center. Cross body, take her back to the wall. For a lunge break. And a right side pass. To a forward break. Back walk 3, main face center. For open break. Natural top 3 to the wall. And a lunge break. A left side pass
takes me away.
And a horseshoe turn.
Boots on my troubles to rest.
To reverse, prepare the Aida. I
there
line,
are
switch,
so many things
and a spot
I
turn the line. And a shoulder to shoulder. Cross body, turn a line and a handshake for your half moon. Start your half moon. Syncopated hip rock, slow, quick, and quick. New Yorker line. At a spot turn reverse. Turning basic. Take her to the center. Cross body, take her back to the wall. For a lunge break. At a right side pass. To a forward break. Back walk 3, and face center for an open break, and a natural top 3 to the wall, for a ones break, a left side pass, and a horseshoe turn. To reverse, prepare the Aida. Aida line and switch. And a spot turn of the line. Shoulder to shoulder. Cross body to the line of the handshake for your half moon. Start your half moon. Syncopated hip rock, slow, quick, and quick. New Yorker to line. And a spot turn to reverse. Turning basic, take her to the center, cross body, take her back to the wall, for a lunge break, a right side pass to close, lunge and shape to your partner. Oh, beautiful dancing, guys.
We enjoy the dancing. Thank you for having us. We really appreciated the opportunity, okay?
Well, we enjoyed it. I enjoyed it too. What I noted about it, I didn't realize you have a collar.
Yes.
Just like you do for square dancing. Yes.
Yep.
Yeah.
That's one of the ways that round dancing differs from ballroom
socially,
dancing.
Yeah.
Because as you noticed, we danced to cues, okay? Yeah. And we danced the cued steps, right?
So, and in the process, you all danced here in one spot, but you really would have been moving around in a circle.
If we had a larger floor, yeah, we would have made a little more progress, yes.
Yeah. But I was impressed with the calling. You know, I was noticed the same calls there for some different steps. And that's the way you keep everybody syncopated.
Exactly.
That's right.
Absolutely.
Okay.
At least we hope they stay syncopated.
So you're looking for some more couples to come out to.
We're
you have to be a couple, or you could be if you get.
It helps to, it helps to be a couple, but if we have two guys or two ladies that would like to dance, what we do is we teach both a man's part and a woman's part.
Okay.
And although the guy can help lead the lady is supposed to know her own figure.
Sure.
Okay.
Yeah. Well, obviously the. They have to. The calls mean something. Each call has a specific movement.
Yes. An explicit figure for each call.
Yeah.
Correct.
Mm-hmm. Well, thank you all very much for coming on. And folks, some of you who like to dance, come on out and
please come out and join us. All right.
That's right.
And although
it's when?
It is 1 to 3. Now every Monday.
Every Monday.
Okay. And we dance over at the convention center. At Hunter's
Crossing.
Normal.
Okay.
Yeah.
What we have done is we're currently doing an intermediate level workshop for folks. But if there's a lot of interest, we'd be certainly willing to restart a basic program. But come on out and at least watch us, and perhaps we can start another basic class.
That would be good. Okay.
We'd love to do it.
Well, thank you all very much for coming. I learned something today. Folks, I think.
Well, come on out and join us, too. You're more than welcome.
Thank you.